published 12.08 est, the 15th of January, the 2018 updated 0109 est, the 16th of January 2018. The Cranberry singer Dolores O'Riordan was dreadfully depressed before her sudden death in a hotel aged 46, friends of a troubled singer have revealed. The Irish rock star was found in a room of the Hilton London in Park Lane at 9:05 a.m. on Monday, while Metropolitan Police said the death was being treated as unexplained. Her publicist did not comment on how she died, other than to say it was sudden and that her family back in Ireland are devastated. Last year, the 46-year-old revealed how she had been battling depression and mental health troubles for much of her career, culminating in an attempt on her own life in 2013. She was diagnosed with bipolar disorder in 2015, and has also spoken of struggling with eating disorders, alcoholism, and living with abuse carried out when she was a little girl. Scroll down for video. This was the rock star's last tweet, posted on January 4th and stating she was heading to Ireland. The Irish rock star pictured left in 2012, who has recently been performing with a band called DARK, was staying in London while recording. The star, pictured with her bandmates in 1999, recently told of troubled times she went through with O'Riordan and her daughter Molly in 2008. She has two other children, a son named Taylor and another daughter called Dakota, as well as a stepson named Donnie. Met Police told Mail Online that O'Riordan was found in a room of the Hilton London in Park Lane, pictured at 9:05 a.m, and that the death was being treated as unexplained. The other members of the Cranberries expressed their devastation at the death of their friend and bandmate in a Twitter post. Friends of the singer said that she was dreadfully depressed in the weeks before her death, according to TMZ, and that she was also suffering from back pain that had forced her to cancel gigs for much of 2017. In a tweet, the other band members wrote, "We are devastated on the passing of our friend Dolores. She was an extraordinary talent and we feel very privileged to have been part of her life from 1989 when we started the Cranberries. The world has lost a true artist today." Noel, Mike and Fergal. Miss O'Riordan had three children with ex-husband Don Burton, a former tour manager for Duran Duran, to whom she was married for 21 years. Their son Taylor, 20, and daughters Molly, 16, and Dakota, 12, live with their father in Canada. A statement from her publicist said Irish and international singer Dolores O'Riordan has died suddenly in London today. She was 46 years old. The lead singer with the Irish band The Cranberries was in London for a short recording session. No further details are available at this time. Family members are devastated to hear the breaking news and have requested privacy at this very difficult time. O'Riordan, who was born in Limerick, last posted a picture of herself with her cat on Twitter on January 4th with the caption, "Bye bye Joe. We're off to Ireland." A Met Police spokesperson said police in Westminster are dealing with a sudden death. Officers were called at 9:05 a.m. on Monday to a hotel in Park Lane. A woman in her mid-40s was pronounced dead at the scene. At this early stage, the death is being treated as unexplained. Inquiries continue. Her band had recently played in South America, and she tweeted pictures of fans in Lima, Peru in December. James Corden and Duran Duran are among the stars to pay tribute to the Cranberries singer. Dolores O'Riordan, comedian and TV star. Corden said he met the singer when he was 15. "She was kind and lovely," he wrote on Twitter. "I got her autograph on my train ticket and it made my day. She had the most amazing voice and presence. So sorry to hear that she's passed away today." Ex Duran Duran said they were crushed to hear the news. "Our thoughts go out to her family at this terrible time," they added. Dave Davies of the Kinks shared a picture of himself with O'Riordan. He said, "I'm really shocked that Dolores O'Riordan has passed so suddenly. I was talking to her a couple weeks before Christmas. She seemed happy and well. We even spoke about maybe writing some songs together. Unbelievable. God bless her." US singer Josh Groban tweeted, "New have always adored her songs and voice." Stars including Beverly Knight, Ronan Keating and Brian McFadden express their sadness at the sudden death. The parish priest from her hometown has confirmed her funeral will take place in Ireland, where she will be buried. Father James Walton, parish priest at Ballybrick in Behamore Parish, said, "I only found out this afternoon. Her family is very devastated and upset. The suddenness of her death has been a shock. I met Dolores two or three times when she was home visiting family. She was a lovely lady. Her family are still waiting for more details to come from London." about her death. The plan is for her to be buried here at home. When that will depend on when her body is released. A spokeswoman for London Hilton, on Park Lane, said it is with deep regret that we can confirm a guest sadly passed away at the hotel on Monday, the 15th of January. We offer our sincere condolences to their family at this difficult time. Team members acted swiftly to alert the Metropolitan Police and we are cooperating fully with their investigation. All further inquiries should be directed to the police. Last year she revealed that she had been diagnosed with bipolar disorder in 2015, having battled with depression during much of her career. She told Metro there are two ends of the spectrum. You can get extremely depressed and dark and lose interest in the things you love to do, then you can get super manic. Dolores O'Riordan from the Cranberries joining Italian singer Zucchero on stage during a benefit show in 2004. I was at the hypomanic side of the spectrum on and off for a long period, but generally you can only last at that end for around 3 months before you hit rock bottom and go down into depression. When you're a manic, you don't sleep and get very paranoid. So I'm dealing with it with medication. The Cranberries last released an album in early 2017, but a US and European tour was cancelled in July due to health reasons concerning O'Riordan. In a statement, the band explained that she was suffering from an ongoing back problem and that doctors had advised her to pull out of all her upcoming gigs. On December 20, O'Riordan tweeted from the band's official account, writing, "Hi all, Dolores here. Feeling good." A spokeswoman for London Hilton confirmed the singer was found in one of its rooms and extended its condolences to her family and friends. "She did my first bit of gigging in months at the weekend, performed a few songs at the Billboard annual staff holiday party in New York with a house band. Really enjoyed it. Happy Christmas to all our fans." O'Riordan split from her husband of 20 years, the former tour manager of Duran Duran, Don Burton, in 2014. In February 2016, O'Riordan said she would use music, dancing and performing to improve her mental health after avoiding a criminal conviction for assault at an airport. She was ordered to pay €6,000 to charity for headbutting, kicking, hitting and spitting on police officers following an alleged air rage incident. The singer had previously admitted 3 assaults and obstructing a police officer after being taken off an Aer Lingus flight from New York's JFK to Ireland on November 10, 2014. Medical reports produced for the trial at Ennis District Court revealed she had been suffering from mania, mental illness and severely impaired judgment at the time of the incident, and that she remembered nothing about it. O'Riordan was mother to son Taylor and daughters Molly and Dakota. President of Ireland Michael D. Higgins led tributes to the singer, saying, "It is with great sadness that I have learned of the death of Dolores O'Riordan, musician, singer and songwriter. Dolores O'Riordan and the Cranberries had an immense influence on rock and pop music in Ireland and internationally. I recall with fondness the late Limerick TD Jim Kemmy's introduction of her and the Cranberries to me, and the pride he and so many others took in their successes. To all those who follow and support Irish music, Irish musicians and the performing arts, her death will be a big loss." Members of the Cranberries hold O'Riordan and pose for a group photo at the 13th annual MTV Video Music Awards in September 1996. Irish band Codeine also offered condolences, writing on Twitter, "Absolutely shocked to hear about the passing of Dolores O'Riordan at the Cranberries. Gave us our first big support when we toured with them around France years ago. Thoughts are with her family and friends." Formed in Limerick, Ireland, the Cranberries became international stars in the 1990s with hits including Zombie and Linger. The band split up in 2003 but reunited several years later, last releasing the acoustic album Something Else in 2017. At home, I'm a housekeeper and a mum. The kids are, like, what's for dinner? Where are my clothes? On tour, it's, like, room service, she said of the comeback. O'Riordan, from Friarstown, Kilmarnock, Co. Limerick, was renowned for her distinctive singing voice. She became a multi-award winning musician after becoming lead singer of the band when she was just 18 and went on to sell tens of millions of records. O'Riordan is seen on stage with the Cranberries in Paris in 2010, left shown right. She is seen on her wedding day in 1994 with husband Don Burton. Right. Duran Duran wrote on Twitter, "We are crushed to hear the news about the passing of Dolores O'Riordan. Our thoughts go out to her family at this terrible time. The Cranberries and DARK frontwoman had been rehearsing in Limerick venue Dolan's Warehouse last month, and had been planning a hometown gig, staff said. A book of condolence is expected to open from 10 a.m. Tuesday morning, at Limerick City and County Council's headquarters at Merchants Quay. Local singer-songwriter Brian O'Connor, who passed on his sympathies to O'Riordan's family and her bandmates, said he was in total shock at news of her death. O'Connor, a close friend of Cranberries guitarist Noel Hogan, described O'Riordan as an icon in the music industry. Paying tribute, he remembered first meeting O'Riordan in the early 1990s, whilst she attended her debut recording sessions with the Cranberries at Xerox Studios, Limerick, run by the band's former manager Piers Gilmore. I knew Dolores in the early days. I remember her being in the recording studio and she was obsessed with instruments and music. I can't believe it. It's absolutely shocking, O'Connor said. It's just a terrible shock. She was a fantastic talent. In fact, she was a great, great iconic figure in Irish music, no doubt about it, he said. She put Limerick on the map. She was a very distinctive singer, more so than anyone else. Just imagine you two without Bono. I feel for her bandmates, but it's worse for her family and her kids, O'Connor added. She was the most iconic Irish singer ever, I think. You can name them all from John McCormack. When you travel abroad and you hear Zombie, and Dreams, and Linger, that's Ireland, that's Limerick. Those songs are played everywhere you go in the world. O'Riordan grew up in the tranquil rural townland of Ballybricken, 17 kilometres from Limerick City. She also lived in Patrickswell. Dolores O'Riordan performs on stage in San Francisco, California, USA in December 1993. The close-knit community of Ballybricken were rallying around O'Riordan's devastated mother Eileen and her six siblings. O'Riordan's father Terry passed away after battling illness in 2011. It's expected the Limerick rock star's remains will be flown home to Ballybricken for burial. However, no funeral plans have been formalised. Bridget Tiffey, a family friend who lives in Ballybricken and is a local independent councillor, was in deep shock at hearing of O'Riordan's sudden death. Oh my God, it's just unbelievable. It's a huge shock for us all here. Dolores was such a talented lady. We are all very proud of her, Tiffey said. Dolores was very close with her mother and family. It's a massive, massive shock. She did so well. She was unbelievable, Tiffey added. Dolores would come and go here all the time. She had been home very regularly. She was world famous, but she was always very grounded and very attached to her native place. She was allowed to be herself here. Formed in Limerick, Ireland, the Cranberries, pictured in 1999, became international stars in the 1990s with hits including Zombie and Linger. Tiffey said that, despite O'Riordan's fame, she never had bodyguards or security with her when she travelled back to Ballybricken. She would always be out running and jogging. She could be herself around here. She was simply Dolores to everybody here. She never had any security with her. She was lovely. Passing on her deepest sympathy to Dolores' own children, her mother, and her wild family, Tiffey added. It's hard to take it in. O'Riordan was also a regular on the jogging trails along the Condell Road in Limerick City, despite being an international music star. She had rehearsed in Limerick music venue Dolan's Warehouse a month ago and was planning to play there soon, staff said. O'Riordan's new music project DARK had to cancel their first ever Limerick gig at Dolan's in 2016, citing O'Riordan's ongoing battle with back pain. Neil Dolan, son of owner Mick Dolan, said everyone at the venue was devastated. She brought Limerick to a global stage and to the forefront of world music. She was an exceptional talent, he said. She was rehearsing here a month ago. It's very, very sad. She seemed a very nice lady. She wanted to do a hometown gig, but it didn't materialize because of her back problems. She was meant to do a gig here with DARK, but couldn't, because of back problems, so they had to cancel. Apparently she had a serious back injury. A lot of her European tour dates were cancelled at the time. The last 2 years of her life, I'd imagine, she was living in a lot of back pain, Dolan added. She's been a superstar since she was a kid. She was quite a private person. Dolores O'Riordan poses with her European Border Breakers Award in 2008, following the release of her solo album Are You Listening? Limerick Metropolitan Mayor Sean Lynch, a former detective who helped put behind bars some of Limerick's most motorists-hardened criminals, said he was so shaken by O'Riordan's death could not bring himself to attend a meeting on the future of policing in the region being held this evening at Thomond Park, the home of Munster Rugby. "I'm absolutely shocked. I couldn't go to the meeting. I can't get over it. I'm totally shocked," Lynch said. "She lived in Patrickswell as a young girl. I wanted to give her a mayoral reception before I ended my tenure. I'm sitting in my car and I just can't believe it. It's such a sad, sad story. She put Limerick on the world stage. Poor Dolores," he added. Paying tribute, Lynch said O'Riordan never ever forgot her roots. "She was Limerick through and through. This is as sad as it gets. She was an icon." Lynch said he admired O'Riordan for many reasons, especially for her strong character. "She was a great role model for all women. I'm sure she opened the doors for females to take a lead role in rock bands, as well as in business. She was bold and tough in an era when the lead singer of a band was nearly always male. She was class act. She was unique. She had a unique voice. She had a great story and everything she sung. She was magic. My deepest sympathies go to her family. What a loss to Limerick. What a loss to Ireland. We won't see the likes of her again," Lynch said. Family friend Canon Liam McNamara, who was a co-celebrant at Dolores' 1994 wedding to 80s rock group tour manager Don Burton in Holy Cross Abbey, Cote Tipperary, told the Limerick Leader newspaper, "My heart goes out to the family. Dolores was their pride and joy. We all loved her very, very much. She got on well all the way through her life. I was very disappointed to hear today that she has left us so early in life. Her family did so much for her and supported her all the way through," added Canon McNamara, who also officiated at the funeral mass of Dolores' father Terry in Ballybricken in 2011. F.R. James Walton, priest in Dolores' home parish of Ballybricken, expressed his deepest sympathies to the family. "I wish to extend my deepest sympathies to the family. I am just going down to meet the family now," F.R. Walton told the Leader. The singer rose to fame in the 1990s with the indie band, most famous for their song Zombie Troubled Life of. Singer who was sexually assaulted as a little girl, suffered mid-air meltdown and admitted she was an accident waiting to happen. Born and raised in County Limerick, Dolores O'Riordan was still in her teens when she answered an advert for a female singer for a rock band called The Cranberry Saw Us. Having written her own songs since she was 12. She tried out for the group by showing off both her lilting vocals and her ability to pen melodies and words for their demos. Existing members Mike and Noel Hogan and Fergal Lawler snapped her up and together they became the Cranberries, increasingly becoming known for O'Riordan's distinctive wailing voice. One of the demos she had worked on for her audition was Linger, which gave the Cranberries a number 3 hit in Ireland in 1993 and proved to be their breakthrough track. More success followed with songs such as Salvation and Zombie, which scooped a coveted Ivor Novello Award. They unveiled their debut studio album, entitled Everybody Else Is Doing It, So Why Can't We, in 1993, and it topped the charts. The singer, pictured in 2000, had continued to perform with other bands since the Cranberry successful follow-ups No Need to Argue and To the Faithful Departed came in 1994 and 1996, cementing the band's status as a mainstream international rock band. To date, the group has sold over 40 million records. But by 2003, it was time for a change and the band announced they were taking some time off to pursue other opportunities. O'Riordan seized the opportunity to pursue a solo career and release the albums Are Listening? 2007 and No Baggage 2009, but while her musical ventures thrived, the singer was battling depression and mental health troubles in her personal life. In an interview in 2013, she said she had been abused as a child, which she said later led to an eating disorder and a breakdown. "I had anorexia, then depression, a breakdown," she said. "I knew why I hated myself. I knew why I loathed myself. I knew why I wanted to make myself disappear." O'Riordan married Don Burton, the former tour manager of Duran Duran, in 1994 and they had 3 children. Her family, she said, were her salvation. But there was more heartbreak ahead, with the singer losing her beloved father in 2011 and her marriage coming to an end in 2014. 2 years later, O'Riordan was ordered to pay €6,000 to charity for headbutting, kicking, hitting and spitting on police officers following an alleged air rage incident. The singer had previously admitted 3 assaults and obstructing a guard after being taken off an Aer Lingus flight from New York's JFK to Ireland in November 2014. O'Riordan's publicist did not comment on how she died, other than to say it was sudden and that her family are devastated. Medical reports produced for the trial at Ennis District Court revealed she had been suffering from mania, mental illness and severely impaired judgment at the time of the incident, and that she remembered nothing about it. Last year she revealed she had been diagnosed with bipolar disorder in 2015. She told Metro, "There are 2 ends of the spectrum. You can get extremely depressed and dark and lose interest in the things you love to do, then you can get super manic. I was at the hypomanic side of the spectrum on and off for a long period, but generally you can only last at that end for around 3 months before you hit rock bottom and go down into depression. When you're a manic, you don't sleep and get very paranoid." The star said she was dealing with it with medication. In another revealing interview, O'Riordan told the Irish News that depression, whatever the cause, is one of the worst things to go through, but that her family had given her happiness. "I've also had a lot of joy in my life, especially with my children," she said. "You get ups as well as downs. Sure, I sent that what life's all about.